guys, welcome to Rise. My name is Sophie, and we want to get to know you guys. So right now, spam the comments. Let us know where you guys are watching from. We want to connect with you guys. Now, right now, let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this moment, for this opportunity, for this privilege to be able to come before you and lift up your name in praise, glory, and honor. We thank you for watching over us throughout the week. We thank you for protecting us through our comings and our goings, Lord God. Right now, at this moment, we lift up those that are sick and shut in, Heavenly Father. We ask that you enter into their homes and you be with them, and that you continue to remind them that you are a God that heals and delivers, Lord God. And as we enter into this service, Father God, we just ask that you be in the midst with us, that you enter into this place with us, Father God. We invite you into this service. We invite you into this place, Father God. And as you are here, Lord God, we ask that you remind us to rise up. Rise up against all the diversity that are in this world. Rise up against all the hate, Father God, that we see each and every day. Rise up against the trials and tribulations that the devil tried to throw our way, Father God. Help us to rise up and represent you. Help us to rise up and reflect you onto this world, Father God. Help us to be the light in the midst of the darkness that floods this world. Continue to be with us throughout this service. Be with your manservant of God, Father God. Let your words be his words. Let your words flow throughout his mouth. In the name of Jesus we pray, amen. Rise up.
There's nothing worth more that could ever come close. Nothing can compare. You're our living hope. Your presence. Whoa. I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of loves. When my heart comes free,
yeah,
and my shame is undone. Yeah, your presence, oh, Holy Spirit, you are welcome. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory.
What's up, Rise fam? I'm Pastor GP, and I pray that you are doing well. If you were here last night, thank you for coming back again. If you're joining us for the first time, we welcome you to the Rise Revival. After every message, like last night, we will be hopping into our Rise room on Zoom to connect, to engage, and I pray that you were encouraged by something that someone else said, or perhaps by a word of encouragement that you were able to give to someone else on their journey as we rise together. So look out for the end of this message. We will be posting that information again for you to meet us in the Rise Room. But for the next 15 minutes, we'll be diving into the Word of God as we rise together once again. If you're ready for the Word of God, let me see you type in the chat. Let's rise. Whether you're watching on Facebook or YouTube, whether you're in your couch or on your bed, type in the chat. Let's rise. Our word for today will be coming from the book of Matthew, the first gospel of the New Testament, Matthew chapter 27, verses 62 to 66. And it reads this way: "The next day, the one after preparation day, the chief priests and the Pharisees went to Pilate. 'Sir,' they said, 'we remember that while he was still alive, that deceiver said, after 3 days, I will rise again. So give the order for the tomb to be made secure until the third day. Otherwise, his disciples may come and steal the body and tell the people that he has been raised from the dead. This last deception will be worse than the first.' 'Take a guard,' Pilate answered. 'Go make the tomb as secure as you know how.' So they went and made the tomb secure by putting a seal on the stone and posting the guard." For the time that is ours to share for the next 15 minutes, I want you to think with me on the thought, "And still I rise. And still I rise." Somebody ought to type that in the chat right now. Engage your fingers and your mind. "And still I rise." These four words summarize the powerful poetry penned by Maya Angelou. But many people do not know that Maya Angelou actually worked with Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. as an activist. So when Martin Luther King Jr. was assassinated on this very day 53 years ago on April 4th, 1968, his death hit Maya Angelou very hard. However, in the face of this tragic occurrence, Maya Angelou ended up writing her first breakthrough memoir, I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings, which was released in 1969. This was followed by additional memoirs, books of poetries, and plays. Then in 1978, And Still I Rise was published. In the face of death, she made a decision to rise above her sorrow and to share the gift that was already in her. And I believe that there just might be two or three people on the broadcast or rebroadcast who found themselves producing in a pandemic, producing in the midst of your pain. Many of us are still finding our purpose, finding our true talents in the midst of this pandemic. So in case you haven't been celebrated yet, in case your resiliency has been overlooked, I want you to go ahead and pat yourself on the back, smile, and say, "And still I rise." Between Zoom meetings for work and virtual school at home, "And still I rise." Despite the heartache and pain of losing loved ones, "And still I rise." Jesus was crucified on a cross and is now dead. Yet we see that the church folks marched up to the headquarters to address the state to bring a petition to seal the tomb, which shows that there were people willing to do whatever it takes to make sure that Jesus stays in the tomb. We shouldn't be surprised that Jesus was a threat even in his death, because if we recall the playback highlight reels of Jesus's life, The levels of hateration were real from the womb to the tomb. Over and over again, Jesus told the disciples that he was going to rise, but it's interesting to see that his enemies seemed to remember what Jesus said, but his own disciples forgot what Jesus said. But you know, Jesus was never ever confined by others' expectations or reactions to his ministry. Jesus could not be pinned down or figured out or boxed in throughout the course of his ministerial experience on this earth. Even in his death, the government dispatched a squad of police to make sure that Jesus would remain locked in that tomb. The word for guard is the Greek word custodia, which means a group of four cops whose shift would change every 4 hours. The changing shifts would assure that there would be 24-hour surveillance around this tomb. So these cops would be awake, attentive, and alert. But they didn't stop there. On top of all these security measures, they planted false evidence at the tomb. The sign that they nailed above Jesus on the cross was their cover-up and justification to the masses as to why his crucifixion was valid. So they placed this Roman seal on the tomb. And if anyone dared to tamper with this seal, would be punished by crucifixion on a cross. So we see they use militarization and intimidation to keep Jesus right where he was. Look how Jesus lays deeply buried in solidarity with those who feel suppressed under the yoke of corruption. Jesus truly was well acquainted with our grief and familiar with the plight of African Americans in America. Oh, it's good to know that we serve a God who was not removed from our own experiences. There is nothing that we have experienced that Jesus Christ has not been through. He is well acquainted with our grief. He was viewed as suspicious. He was falsely accused. He was misrepresented in court. He received a horrible verdict and he was executed on a Friday. They saw Jesus die on the cross in agony, and they thought, that this would be the end of him. They thought that they had Jesus locked, but little did they know that Jesus was loaded and that their victory would be short-lived. When the forces of death declared the end, Jesus victoriously responded, "To be continued." And perhaps there's somebody listening tonight or watching the rebroadcast, listening under the sound of my voice or watching, looking into my eyes, who is locked and buried under the yoke of a situation that seems to be impenetrable. Maybe it's a sickness that seems to be sealed. Maybe you feel trapped in your predicament. But when we look at the resurrection of Jesus Christ, we are reminded of the fact that even though he was locked on a Friday, that Jesus was still loaded. How do we know this? Well, because early Sunday morning, Jesus got up with all power in his hands. Jesus could not be confined by the restraints and constraints of the tomb. Although they tried to keep him locked, yet he still rose as the champion of the world. Death could not hold him. The grave could not keep him. The guards couldn't regulate him. He defeated the demons of hell and dropped death in the mouth, because nothing can stop the resurrection and the life. He has all power in his hands. And even when man tries to plot and plan, their plans cannot prevail against the all-powerful God. I can almost hear Jesus saying, "You may shoot me with your words. You may cut me with your eyes. You may kill me with your hatefulness, but still I'll rise. You may write me down in history with your bitter, twisted lies. You may tread me in the dirt and lock me in the tomb, but still, I'll rise." Jesus arose from the dead as evidence that he had satisfied God with his sacrifice for our sins. The tomb couldn't keep him. The guards couldn't explain him. The armies couldn't defeat him. The governments couldn't unseat him. And even computers can't delete him. He's the undefeated champion of love. Jesus has conquered death. Death is our greatest enemy. Oh, I serve a risen Savior, and he's in the world today. I know that he is living, whatever men may say. I see his hand of mercy. I hear his voice of cheer. And just the time I need him, he's always near. He lives. He lives. Christ Jesus lives today. He walks with me and talks with me along life's narrow way. He lives. He lives. Salvation to impart. You ask me how I know he lives? He lives within my heart. And because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds the future. My life is worth the living just because he lives. And Romans 8:11 says that the same power that raised Jesus from the dead is the exact same power that's inside of you. Yep, that's right. It's in the word. Romans 8:11. The same power that resurrected Jesus from the grave is the same power available to you and I. So the seals that society tries to place around you, you may be locked financially. You may be locked emotionally. You may be battling with your insecurities. You may be locked at home in quarantine. But you still can rise. So since I'm loaded with his promises and loaded with his power, I'm not buried. Nah, I'm not buried. I'm just planted. You're not buried. You're just planted. So you can throw me to the wolves, but I'll come back leading the pack. Too many of us are living defeated lives, living chained to fear, living locked to our problems and predicaments. But I stopped by here today to let you know that the resurrection power is relevant and real. The same power that resurrected Jesus is the same power available to you today. Because Jesus died and rose, you can live as an overcomer. You can live as a champion. All you have to do is accept this precious gift of salvation. Because the same power that rose Jesus from the tomb is the same power available to get you out of your tomb. So rise, fam. It's time to rise. All you have to do is to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. You don't have to stay locked in that tomb, Rise Fam. You can rise. No matter what you've been through, no matter what you've done, no matter what situation you face today or you may face tomorrow, and still, you can rise. So as the song is sung tonight, I want to encourage you to make Jesus your choice. I want to encourage you to type in the chat, "And still I rise." And still I rise. If you want to say yes to Jesus, type in the chat, "And still I rise." And we will connect with you and help you rise on your spiritual journey.
But time will
Thank you for joining the Rise Revival. We want to give you an opportunity to make a difference in the lives of young people in northern New Jersey. Give to the Rise Scholarship Fund, a scholarship dedicated to assisting the educational and artistic development of children and young people. To give to the Rise Scholarship, go to codosda.org. You can give right there on our website via AppLoss by mailing a check, or if you have Cash App, our cash tag is $CODOSDA. That's $CODOSDA. As you give, be sure to include RISE in the memo. Let's partner together to help the next generation rise.